थोड़ा हल्का हो ले भाई।
Last decade saw a gigantic leap in the action genre of both Indian and foreign cinema, where superheroes started becoming more mainstream and a divergence began from CGI and computer effect based fight scenes to more grounded and realistic fights. Last decade contains some of the best cinematic spectacles in the history of cinema. From Avengers to Bahubali, franchises have produced a millennium worth of spectacle for the world. Not only Bollywood, the whole of Indian cinema pushed for better movies and even better fight scenes. Not only that, last decade gave us the best masculine action hero of all times, Tiger Shroff. Special effects used in the Indian movies have obviously started to look much better than the crap we got in the decades before the previous one, with a few exceptions. All this makes one wonder where exactly India will go from here. But the question is, who among these action giants have proved to be the best? Which action fight scene do I think will stand the test of time for me and remain to be the best fight scene in Bollywood? Ek villain is not that grand of a movie like Bahubali or Magadhira. Not only is its budget low, but it is also not really known for its fight scenes. It is remotely known for the par excellence performance of Ritesh Deshmukh, who is one of the best villains in Bollywood in my opinion. Siddharth Malhotra's push kick fetish and that one song which is still in every Dil Jale Aashiq's playlist. And who can forget the Robert De Niro of Bollywood who acted in it? But never its fight scenes. It is never known for its fight scenes. And it actually upsets me to think that, because it is one of the first movies in Bollywood that introduced long and sort of lazy camera movements and a grounded approach to fights, before Tiger Shroff perfected it, of course. Even the reviewers at that time, though acclaimed the movie, didn't really give its fight scenes a second thought. So the question is, why do I think that it has the best fight scene in Bollywood? The last fight scene of Ek Villain is the best fight scene of Bollywood for many reasons. Now notice how I said Bollywood here. It's because I haven't really seen a lot of regional cinema and I want them to have the benefit of the doubt. For simplicity of this video, I took a literal definition to a fight scene, that is violence. So scenes from many movies were included but excluded all of Tiger Shroff's fight scenes, because they are not really fight scenes, they are more of a dance scenes. Not complaining, just my opinion. Also, Tiger Shroff's fight scenes were excluded because that alone are better than all the fight scenes in the world combined. I am to give other fight scenes a chance too, right? The whole movie is essentially a long fight scene with some breaks here and there. It rejects the classic Bollywood cliches that are still deeply rooted in the minds of both the makers and the watchers of these movies. Ek Villain's last fight scene does a lot of things really good, which I'll get to in a moment. But just cause it did a lot of things right doesn't mean that it's perfect. It has its fair share of flaws, but what is right here outweighs what is bad.
Madam, he is 2 rupees.
The fight takes place in Nisha's room, around which most of the plot of the movie revolves. The movie starts in a room and essentially ends in a room. So it is really important that we know the room well. And we are shown the room through the opening credits of the movie. We are shown many objects in the room that provide a lot of information about the person that lives there. Without a single dialogue, the opening credits of the movie give an indication that this is a happy and a joyous atmosphere and that this is going to remain as the mood of the movie. Most of the impressionable and naive audience often does this mistake. They judge the mood of the movie with how it begins. Batman's parents were killed in the beginning, so the mood will be sad. A silly girl sings a song, then the mood will be happy. Now this is the core here. If we want to understand why the last fight scene of this movie is so great, we have to look at the beginning of the movie. The movie begins with Aisha taking Lord Ganesha's idol to her room, but there is a hole in the road right in front of her house for telephone lines repair work. Just as any normal human being would, Aisha scolds the guy working the telephone lines. The guy later turns out to be the very killer who kills Aisha after that very moment and takes her necklace. More on that later. After Aisha's death, the room is absolutely changed. What seemed in the beginning as a nest of Guru and Aisha's dreams has now been bastardized by Rakesh's heinous crime, and it stays this way till the very end of the movie. The glass stays broken, the bookshelf which Rakesh crashed on Aisha stays there. Remember the bookshelf, it's important. So the starting credit scene of the movie ends with Aisha's murder by Ritesh. The main mood of the movie is established right at the beginning of the movie and is subverted with Aisha's fall. Literally. Typical Bollywood cliches like the main characters will not die and hero will somehow come right at time to save Aisha are also subverted. I have to be honest here, I was like, no way she's dead, she's like alive in some way. But the fact that she stayed dead elevated this movie in my opinion. Audience is therefore left to wonder, what now? The rest of the movie is essentially a long fight scene, a cat and mouse game if I can call it, where Siddharth is essentially trying to impart revenge by diligently beating up Ritesh every time he can, and Ritesh just trying to survive. For the remainder of the movie, these are the main motives of the characters. Guru goes on a path of rampage and destruction. Ritesh continues to let his anger out on innocent women and staying on the defense. This, however, changes when Ritesh takes the offensive stance against Guru and starts to hurt Guru. All the while, police is just trying to contain these two. Movie contains a lot of flashback of both Guru and Ritesh's life that set up where these men are coming from. All of this leads to our last fight. The fight is not that well choreographed, which is perfect in my opinion. Because as someone who has been in confrontations myself, I know that fights are never so organized as other martial art movies portray them to be. Even when trained fighters fight, fights are usually sloppy. Tell me honestly, what is more entertaining? A guy doing backflips and fancy kicks, or just two guys going berserk at each other? This is what I think gives edge to this fight scene. Anyway, at this point in the whole movie, it is already established that Guru is the most superior fighter between the two, and the trend continues here also. Meanwhile, Rakesh, the lily-livered pussy, stays on the defensive in the beginning, which later turns out to be a trap. Okay, now tell me, where have you seen this shot before? Any guesses? No? Oh god, you guys can't even guess this bit? You can't trust anyone these days, you have to do
everything yourself, don't we?
What about this shot? Doesn't it look similar to this? The relationship between Rakesh and Guru is made to mimic a Joker and Batman scenario. And the best thing about such antagonists is that the resulting conflict is so heavy with emotions that you feel the impact of every single punch. Accented Cinema, a famous and much popular YouTube channel than ours, addressed this in their famous video, How to Write a Superman. In that video, they explained that against an all-superior protagonist, only those antagonists prevail who nullify their superiority and strength. Cause there is nothing. In this scene right here, Rakesh nullifies Guru's superiority because he has positioned himself in a way where he wants to die. He wants to die because he thinks that this will make him a hero in his wife's eyes, which is his purpose in this movie all along since the very beginning. He kills innocent girls, he kills innocent women, and takes a souvenir from them to give to her wife as a sign that he loves her. And Rakesh's wife, Suru, diligently takes advantage of him. That is, of course, until the tables are turned again when Guru's boss threatens to kill Suru. Another thing I would like to point out here is that this was the same bookshelf that Rakesh crushed Aisha with. Aisha was in the same place in the beginning, begging for her life, where the mobile is right now, through which Suru is begging for her life. Here, he knows his wife will die, so in a frenzy, he tries to undo what he did to Aisha, but it's too late now. He's as helpless as Guru was in the beginning of the movie. Yes, he takes the shelf off, but there's no Aisha beneath it, who begged for the life of a child and herself. Only the final screams of the woman he loved and the woman he married. And Rakesh's wife, Suru, also dies. At this point, whatever sanity was left in Rakesh is long gone, and he charges at Guru with all the hatred, with no regard to his own life, and they both fall down on the same road. Guru, who has been stabbed twice now, is at the mercy of this monster. Rakesh picks up a rock to smash Guru's head. Okay, so a car hits him. Some people I showed this to found it lame, but in my opinion, this ending right here is what elevated this fight scene to the best fight scene in Bollywood. Now the director here portrayed it as a sort of divine intervention, where it was Lord Ganesha himself who saved Guru. But my perspective to this scene is different than the director's, which makes all the difference. Remember in the beginning Rakesh was working on those very telephone lines and this hole in the road? This is the best ending because in the end, villain is defeated not by anyone else but by his own deeds. This was the hole that Rakesh dug himself, and his incompetence is what led to both his and his family's demise. His wife dies because of his toxic love for her, and he dies himself because of his inability and incompetence in the job. In this movie, we are shown the journey of two villains who choose different paths, and in the end, both of them die. And a good man remains. In the end, Guru could have easily fulfilled his revenge by killing Rakesh's son, but he chose not to do it. That is what made this ending more satisfying to me. In this way, this last fight and its ending was the most satisfying that ever came out of Bollywood. It's not just a fight scene, it's a poetry. This makes me wanna improvise a bit. So this one is dedicated to Rakesh and Suru. Death, like all good things, shall be enjoyed with the people you love. It is really frustrating to see that gems like Ek Villain and other good quality Indian movies fade away into oblivion so quickly, when these are the kind of movies we need today. And things have improved. We have such content driven movies like Andhadhun, Kabil are gaining much more support and things are looking good. But it's sad to see that the same has not been happening to the action or fight choreography department of Bollywood. Apart from Tiger Shroff's scene, of course, their beauty. In conclusion, I don't disregard action scenes from Bahubali or other action franchises. But in my personal opinion, violence is a really pristine thing. It's almost a rare case nowadays to witness true violence. You have to go all the way to Aminabad, Hazratganj or Kasabagh to see real violence. And it's not that easy to create too. I mean, tell me, what is more creative, a flying roundhouse kick to the face or this shot, which tickles me cause it reminds me of this shot. But at the same time, it's not that hard either. All it takes to make the best fight scene is a respect for violence and its consequences, because violence is a weird form of art, but it's not dancing.
नमस्कार साथियों, आप सबका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया मनप्रीत की वीडियो देखने के लिए.
सो वी लॉन्च दिस वीडियो टुडे बिकॉज वी थॉट दैट बिकॉज ऑफ जनता कर्फ्यू मच ऑफ द ऑडियंस ऑफ आर्स विल बी एट होम टुडे एंड वी थॉट वील एंटरटेन दैम विद आर वीडियो एंड वी होप वी एंटरटेन यू टुडे एंड डू शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू आर चैनल इफ वी डेड. सो आदित्य, विल यू प्लीज मेक पीपल अवेयर अबाउट सम थिंग्स दैट दे शुड नो अबाउट कोरोना एंड थिंग्स दे शुड एंड शुडंट डू.
सो देखिए, जो रिकॉर्ड केस अभी तक हुए हैं वो 300 के पार पहुंच चुके हैं इंडिया में. 196 या 200 समथिंग जो है अभी प्रोसेस में ट्रीटमेंट चल रहे हैं, और 4 लोगों की अभी तक डेथ हो चुकी है और 23 से ज़्यादा लोगों ने अभी रिकवर कर लिया है. जनता कर्फ्यू आज लागू हुआ है सुबह के 7 बजे से रात के 9 बजे तक लागू नहीं हुआ. एक तरह से देशवासियों से मोदी जी ने अपील की है कि हम इसे फॉलो करें, और लोगों को, आप खुद को ही नहीं बचा रहे, आप दूसरों की भी जान बचा रहे हैं घर पे रह के. वायरस कॉन्टैक्ट से ही फैलता है और सर्फेसेस पे कई घंटे से लेकर कई दिनों तक भी रह सकता है, हवा में ये 3 घंटे तक रह सकता है. तो इसीलिए अगर हम बाहर ना जाएं तो हम इसे अवॉइड कर सकते हैं, इसके आउटब्रेक को रोक सकते हैं. फेज 3 चल रहा है जो कि सबसे ख़तरनाक फेज़ होता है इस वायरस का. इसी वक्त पर स्पाइक आता है. अभी हमें ग्राफ को फ्लैटन आउट करना है ताकि हम इसके स्प्रेड को रोक सकें. अगर हमने अभी कंटेन कर लिया तो सिचुएशंस वर्स होने से बच जाएंगी, परिस्थितियां विपरीत नहीं होंगी.
ऑल्सो यूज हैंड सैनिटाइजर्स और सोप एंड वाटर टू वॉश योर हैंड्स रेगुलरली. इट इजंट दैट यू आर स्टेइंग एट होम देन यू आर दैट यू आर कंप्लीटली सेफ. यू हैव टू वॉश योर हैंड्स एवरी 1 आवर विद हैंड सैनिटाइजर्स, अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर्स और सोप एंड वाटर टू मिनिमाइज द चांसेस ऑफ कोरोना एंड हेल्प द गवर्नमेंट एंड हेल्प द ह्यूमैनिटी इन दिस बैटल अगेंस्ट कोरोना.
यू मे हेट मोदी बट सपोर्ट दिस इनिशिएटिव. यू आर नॉट doing yourself a favor, but you are also saving lives of many people.
Yeah, true that. So on that note, we'll be taking a leave now and hope you are all safe and you are all comfortable and Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.